You actually thought I was gonna show you the drop first? Yeah right bro. Anyways, back on topic. Today I'm gonna be teaching you guys how to make an EDM drop like the good old days of EDM. So pretty much if we go back in time, the golden days of EDM would totally have to take places from 2011 to probably around late 2015. Honestly, it could just be because of the fact of nostalgia could be why people quote unquote miss the old EDM days, because life was so much simpler. But then again, everyone makes pop and the music industry is kinda lame nowadays. To me, some of the greats from the golden EDM days would have to probably be Cruella, Vice Tone, Zedd, Avicii, Nicky Romero, the Swedish House Mafia, Afrojack, Tiesto, and even Axwell and Sebastian Ingrosso, who we all know had their own duo apart from SHM. Anyhow, let's jump into this tutorial. Today I'm going to be remaking one of my favorite EDM tracks of all time. Red Lights by Tiesto. First things first, the melody. Next thing I did was remade the chords. Here's what they sound like together. Now I just copied the melody and pasted them into some lead sounds. I kept the layers pretty small. I only added 7 layers. Don't try and overdo it to try and make a fatter sound. You're only making it harder to mix and honestly is just unnecessary. So just keep the layers down. Here are the following sounds I used for the leads. Altogether they sound like this. For the mixing I kept it pretty simple. All I added was reverb, sidechain, and some echoing. You're probably like, bro, where the fuck is the OTT? I didn't like it, so. It sounded mushy and bad. So now you're all probably like, bro, what about that compression? To make up for it, I added some the glue onto the master with the radio squash preset. Now make some drop chords, remember to not overdo the layers. As you see, I only have 3 layers. Most people would do like 5 to 6 layers thinking it'll do you better. I mean it can, but just don't put yourself onto too much stuff when you don't have to. Good mixing with good sounds and a good master will do the trick. First thing, a simple saw chord sound. Then I layered it with another one. Finally, a nice piano sound that's kind of fat a little. For the EQ, I did pretty much the same as the leads, just some reverb, OTT, eching, Lots of sidechain and that's about it. Next thing I did was I added two mid basses that sound crunchy. This time around I did a little bit more for the mixing. I really wanted to get that old organic, crunchy bass sound. Kinda learned it from Kashmir, but I just love having crunchy and fat basses. They fill up the drop a lot so you don't have to layer many other sounds and can allow you to create a easier and more healthy mix down. For the mix I just added some Camel Crusher which adds more crunch, some EQ which I got rid of low ends which are unnecessary since the sub bass will do that and we don't want the two to clash. Also the EQ gets rid of some high ends which I don't really like since we will add some high end stuff in the drums and effects. Lastly I added some OTT for some compression and kickstart which is some sidechain. Lastly I added a sub that was also really attacky which made for more groove and I really like it. Now for the drums and effects I added a lot of stuff to be honest. So let's go over what I put and why. Number 1 a punchy kick, make sure it isn't too loud and under compressed. Number 2 I added a punchy and kinda snappy clap. Number 3 is pretty common, just a simple ride loop. I however removed some low ends and added a little bit of sidechain so it doesn't interfere with the click of the kick. Then based of what I heard in the original there was a bunch of loops that had snares and claps and whatnot, so that's why I did. Then I just went ahead and made my own clap loop that had some reverb on it. Some crashes and downlifters and whatnot. You get it. And that I also added a vocal ambient so it gave some more emotional vibes. I also added this shaker loop from one of Kashmir's sample packs, it gives the drop more groove. Then I just layered more claps, a hi-hat loop and some more effects. I added this white noise ride thing that I said earlier in the video that we'd bring back some higher end stuff. Then a crowd loop to fill up the drop more. And then yes, yet another loop gives more bounce and groove kinda like the original. A ride loop. And yes, okay, I'm done, last one. One more loop, this has some quiet clap loops and toms to give more groove yet again. Then some rides, and next another downlifter thing. Then I also added this cool like white noise sweep up every 4 bars, it fills up the drop a lot. Lastly I added some more loops, and also added a white noise sample from Kashmir's sample pack. And finally for the drums I added one more crash and one more loop. Altogether they sound like this. I almost forgot, I added this nice ARP that fills the atmosphere up. We could just swim them red lines.